Now question arises, then how we can make classroom more innovative? What could be the possible diverse ways to make classroom more innovative? There are various ways from which we can make our classroom more innovative. This is the major challenge for a teacher, how to achieve each student's attention and how to deliver the ideas effectively enough for a respectful classroom and impression. You know, in our classroom, in the group, there are high learners, there are slow learners. And as a teacher, it is your duty that you take care of each and every student. Therefore, by following some of the ideas, we may create our classroom more innovative, more lively, and more vibrant. By following some of the ideas, we may create our classroom more innovative and vibrant. The creative teaching by brainstorming and using audio and video tools. When we go for audio, it may not be so catchy. But when we also go for video tools, it may be more catchy. In making classroom more innovative, teachers may take help of teaching tools in the form of games or visual exercises and brainstorming sessions, which will stimulate young minds and generate their interest. Brainstorming sessions are called significant and vital ways to get the inspired juices flowing. Means when ideas come from different minds, we can go for a collaborative outcome. So that way, by encouraging multiple brains to focus on one idea, teacher may catch plentiful ideas. This process will also increase participation of each and everyone in the class. We don't have to discourage the students from the ideas. Let ideas be there. But teacher has to think of diversity of the ways to cultivate their creative ideas. This can be done by encouraging and giving freedom to the students to discover different ideas. Teachers may incorporate audiovisual materials in their lectures. Further, there can be in the form of model, short movies, pictures, slide presentations, and other mind mapping and brain mapping skills, and other number of smart applications that will help to develop understanding the concept in a better way. These tools also help in enhancing and improving vis-a-vis enriching the critical understanding of ability of problem solving, ability of blossoming the imagination. So these need to be fostered in the class. Then we go for real world experience. Teachers may infuse real world experience in their lessons, as it will enrich classroom learning with life skills. Life skill has become very important aspect nowadays. Highly educated people may not have life skills. So teaching life skill is also the duty of the teacher. That way, we need to give them real world experience. By reflecting and demonstrating the concept with real life situations, the understanding of the lesson will become stress free and easy to learn. It will also spark the interest of learner and the teacher, where they will feel excited and involved. Next element here comes, teaching technology outside the classroom. Some people will say, what is outside? Everything is in the classroom. No, friends, there's a famous statement of learning outside from four walls of the classroom, which may be associated with teaching technology outside the classroom situation. Some contents are learnt best when they are taught outside the boundaries of the class. Organization of field trips that are relevant to the lessons to justify. Moreover, students can be allowed to walk outside for the class, as it will increase many more innovations in the students. So as a whole, without taking much of the efforts, they will learn and remember what you intended to teach. Because classroom behavior, a behavior of the student in the classroom and outside the classroom, you'll find it different. You can find independent thinking in the student. Then comes role playing and the simulations. See, role playing basically is an excellent teaching tool, with the help of which a teacher can develop interpersonal skills among their students. This strategy is convenient in teaching the literary concepts, historical facts, and contemporary issues. Role play method, it tries to connect the learner with the content matter and real and everyday task. So that way, motivating and inspiring classroom environment comes at the core again. Teacher must enter the classroom very smiling. When a classroom is well decorated with an academic input, it will help to motivate the students and inspire the heart and mind of the students. This will stimulate the classroom environment, learning will become more easy, and here in this environment, you can also go for other methods like puzzles and the games. Game playing within the class, puzzles, they will increase innovation and creativity among the students. The educational experience will become enjoyable and puzzles and games become part of it. When lessons are introduced through games and puzzles, it helps the learner to think critically, creatively, and problem solving of the issue at hand. It will generate a feeling of personal connection. For educational innovations, it is necessary for a teacher to connect with his learner and the current trends of the education. Through this connect, a teacher can be successful in teaching the lesson and course material in an innovative way. But things cannot stop here. Things need to go beyond. And here, we need to design the interactive lesson with support of technology. Because we are in new age. We are in a change phenomena, change scenario. Innovative and creative teacher is always in search for more interactive, interesting, and amazing lessons which are supported by technology. Friends, these technological enriched lessons will definitely make teaching lively and long-lasting. They also increase their students' willingness to learn and classroom engagements. And it will be long-lasting. But we need to make priority what is most important. Prioritize the things. A teacher must know about the priorities of his personal and professional life. A teacher need to look beyond the personal work and targets by looking beyond the individual situations and instead need to look at it from the eyes of the students, means the element of empathy. It signifies that by using empathy, a teacher will truly be able to bring about innovation. Be the change which you want to bring in others. So, here involves the element of empathy. One has to find ways to bridge the gap in between traditional image of the teacher by creating an encouraging supportive environment in the class, and at the same time, this will automatically enhance students' engagement, thereby increasing the teaching efficacy. A sound mind rests in a sound body. So, mindset of the teacher. Teaching attitude of a teacher will surely change the mindset. Mindset of the teacher will affect the delivery and the content. Therefore, the mood of the learners further leads to overall classroom learning environment. This is the teacher who sets the tone of the classroom from entering a classroom till he leaves the classroom. Students like, praise, and follow the dedicated and committed teachers. Teachers must have passion for their teaching profession. Designing and delivering the learning context is based on teacher mindset, which is central to innovative learning and the entire processes. So that way, professional development courses must be taken into consideration. That training should be based on students' point of view, not from the teacher's point of view, to explore new innovation. Means the training of the teachers should be student-oriented instead of teacher-oriented. Self-reflection. Self-reflection is concerned with a way of self-analysis. Self-analysis by whom? By the teachers. While using instructional strategies, what they are teaching is equivalent with students' response. I mean, there has to be a parity in between response and the stimulus. If we expect a response from the students, do we give the same type of the stimulus? This is significant concept for teaching profession, for analyzing and assessing what should be and what should not be in their instructional style and instructional strategies. They can evaluate their own teaching style, own pedagogy in the form of teaching strategies. The delivery mechanism and finding classroom success, it can always be improved. So therefore, the teacher need to create flexible learning environment. Rigidity in the classroom will mar content, creativity and learning element of the students. It is crucial for a teacher to plan and make strategy how to use classroom space. When we talk of classroom space, the classroom space should be more spacious, where students would be able to work alone, interact with peers, and find place for the collaborative activities. Learning spaces should not be rigid but flexible, which support one-to-one teaching, collaboration, critical and independent thinking, and group discussions. So that is about the classroom space. Then personality of the teacher also matters. Herein, all teachers, they need to create a place for all learners. Researches have revealed that the critical differences between introverts and extroverts is that extroverts are more comfortable in social interactions. They get energy and enthusiasm, where introverts magnify their energy from silent zone and to think and reflect alone. Hence, it is must for the extroverts, for growing their potential, that they should be given group work discussions. Contrarily, for introverts, growth and potential, there should be focus on reflection or individual research, and from this, introverts can become thrive and blossom. They can also become easily annoyed or get in trouble for trying to get attention. Talking, speaking in or on social media and becoming disruptive. Whenever possible, teachers can offer students options of working in groups or on their own. Extroverts can compete with projects alone, and introverts can choose to collaborate both for. Both for these ways of teaching are critical to meet the needs of different learner segments. Therefore, teachers who provide activities that best engage, inspire, and sustain students' love for learning are more prone to that they put their best efforts. They enjoy the process and find the positive results. So we also here next we also need to go for problem solving. Use problem solving and finding. There is a concept of problem discovery, which is very popular as compared to problem solving. Problem finding is more important as compared to problem solving. So problem discovery can be done with the help of students to look at surroundings by exploring gaps to fill and use the problem findings. This process can be done with the help of problem sharpening, problem shaping, and problem solving together. In problem finding process, it requires a logical and inspired vision to search for what might be missing or what should be added to something improvement. From this strategy, students can be equipped with the skill of critical understanding, creative expressions, and problem solving. Then again, it is the duty of the teacher. He encourages the students to take risk and fail. Students need to experience failure to learn. The person who has not seen failure in the life cannot enjoy the success. When teachers provide real-world projects that give students problem to solve, they are offering a platform for the students to learn from the failure, step up again and again to eventually find success. Failure should be taken as individual students' growth, and it is the duty of the teacher that along with the success, they also teach the students how to deal with failure. Learners should be challenged with real-world problems to tackle and let them fail and try again. It gives them a confidence that their voice matters. The pedagogy of 21st century, friends, it is based upon inquiry and innovation as compared to traditional pedagogy, which is based upon role memory, which is based upon rote memory. Herein comes the role of flipped classroom. Because technology is there, flipped classroom could be a model for the future. The main attraction of 21st century classroom is flipped classroom. This flipped classroom model is reverse with traditional model of teaching. In this model, teaching and classroom events, they are in reverse order. Before coming to the class, students are given homework or task, and they can view lectures material in the form of PDF and videos. In class, teacher and the students would take part in various activities concerned with reflection and observation of the prescribed lecture. This would also lead to peer-to-peer learning, group discussion, and self-directed learning. So after discussing this all, it's time to conclude. And as conclusion, we can say that pedagogical innovations are emblem of excellence towards quality concerns in our educational experiences. The specific term is associated with creation and innovation of new and unique ideas in various instructional techniques that will promote the learning in more effective and exciting ways. There are 7 notions of pedagogical innovations which have different attributes. They are like novelty, change, application, and improvement, technopedagogy, reflection, and human reactions. There are various characteristics of the pedagogical innovations which make it unique. The model also highlights different characteristics of the innovative teachers and explored various ways how to bring innovation in the classroom, from which pedagogical practices are used for larger interest of the students and the academics. With this, we conclude here. Thank you so much. Wishing you happy learning.